Hello everybody! Today we are going to use only two lip twists to make many different sculptures. Usually I try to avoid stretching balloons to prevent any deformation. Today we are going to stretch balloons quite a lot. Please be gentle when you're stretching balloons. Applying too much force on balloons will break them on pieces. In the following example we are going to make a sculpture of pacifier. Usually we inflate and work bubbles starting from the nozzle end of the balloon. Today we have to inflate balloons starting from the opposite end of the balloon. Balloons usually start inflating at the weakest point. We create this weak point by stretching the balloon couple times. Stretch the very end of the balloon couple times and then inflate balloon making about 3 inch long bubble. If the temperature in my apartment was more than 70 degrees Fahrenheit, the balloon would inflate at the opposite end where we stretch it couple times. Well, now I have to force the bubble to the opposite end. You have to make about no more than 1/4 inch of flat tail at the very end of the balloon, right here. Alright, now we have to make the tulip twist. We have to force nozzle about 2 inch deep inside of the bubble. Grab the nut with your left hand and twist the bubble. Right finger still is inside of the bubble. Hold the first bubble with your left hand and gently pull your right finger out of the bubble. Congratulations, we have made tulip twist. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. We have made a pacifier. We can use it as a bracelet. Please keep in mind it is not a real pacifier, just a regular balloon. We do not give balloons to toddlers. And we better keep balloons away from the face. On my website feedoit.com you may find links to different instructions how to make tulip twist in different ways. Check out instruction indestructible bubble. Now I'm going to use blue balloon to make the same pacifier. Tulip twist can be very difficult for some people to learn. It was quite hard for me, that's for sure. However, years back when I mastered it, I taught my kids to do tulip twist. To my own surprise, they made the tulip twist from the very first attempt. Well, anyway, it takes time to master everything. Making tulip twist is essential skills. Today we are going to practice it a lot to make it perfect. For this particular sculpture, size of bubbles is very important. The bubble at the end of the balloon, we have to make it a bit larger size than the first bubble we twist. And it must have nice round shape. Alright, let's make a pacifier. Inflate bubble at the end of the balloon, leaving about no more than 1/4 inch of flat tail at the very end of the balloon. Use one of your right fingers to force nozzle of the balloon inside of the bubble. Hold the bubble with your left hand. Force the nozzle about halfway through the bubble. Grab the nozzle with your left hand and twist the first bubble. Now you have to hold the first bubble with your left hand and then gently pull the right finger out of the bubble. Now let's fix bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations again, we have made pacifier. Pull the nut inside of the first bubble to secure it. The pressure inside of the bubble holds the nut properly. Here's the first pacifier, I made it out of clear red balloon, so you can actually see what's inside of the first bubble. Here's the bottom view and the side view. This sculpture is fun decoration for any birthday party. In the following example, we are going to make a ghost. In this example, I'm going to use white color balloon. Work it with tulip twist in the same basically way as we did the pacifier. The only difference is the size of the bubbles. We start by inflating 4-inch long bubble. We have to force the bubble to the opposite end of the balloon, away from nozzle, leaving about 1-inch long flat tail at the end of the balloon. Force the nozzle about 3-inch deep inside of the balloon. At this point you twist the first bubble, pull out your finger out of the balloon. You can leave little flat tail at the end of the balloon. It actually makes our sculpture look better. Here you can see the difference in proportions of the bubbles. Now I'm going to use a black permanent marker to draw the eyes, nose, smile. Also we can draw arms, legs. I'm gonna draw some kind of wings. Congratulations, we have made a ghost. We can wear it as a ring or as a bracelet. Once again, there are only two differences: size of the bubbles and color of the balloons. In the following example, I'm going to use green color balloon to make sculpture of apple, or it could be green tomato. This time we have to inflate no more than 2-inch long bubble, about one no more than 2-inch away from the nozzle. Now let's tie a knot about 1-inch away from the nozzle. For the bubble, back to the knot. For the knot, through the bubble to the upper side end of the bubble. At this end, you grab the knot with your left hand. Lock both ends of the bubble in one lock twist. And then you can gently pull your right finger out of the bubble. Now we can kind of roll the bubble towards the nozzle. Make sure the nozzle protrudes right above the bubble. The nozzle represents apple's butt, and the long balloon tail represents the stem. We can make the stem shorter. Just tie a simple knot at any spot where you want. The rest of the balloon you can cut off with the scissors. We can use different color balloons to make apples, yellow, gold. Also use red color balloons to make tomatoes. We can use smaller size bubbles to make cherry sized tomato or even cherry, why not? Inflate no more than 2-inch long bubble. Tie the balloon about 1-inch away from the nozzle. And then make a tulip twist same way as we did previously. Fix the nozzle protruding right above the bubble. Congratulations again, we have made a cherry. Once again, you can make the stem of any size you want, cut off the rest of the balloon. As you can see, today we use only tulip twist to make many different sculptures. We can use all those sculptures as it is, all those fruits we can attach to the trees, and all those sculptures we can use as a decoration for the Christmas tree. Also, I mentioned before, we can use some of the sculptures as bracelets or rings. Well, that's all for today. Have fun and happy twisting!